a business idea once glittered your mind, I believe, and literally illuminated your body as you saw yourself succeeding in it. I think a lot of us, if you are like me, a lot of us get very excited when the business idea began and you saw yourself making it big time. Sometimes you saw yourself, you know, I have a friend who has a habit of doing calculations and looking at, you know, the possibility of breakthroughs even in the coming year. And you calculate it only to discover that things are very different on the ground. As they say, vitu ni tofauti kwa ground. Okay? So you have a business idea, it once glittered your mind, and you literally illuminated your body as you saw yourself succeeding in it. But you are in business basically because there is a problem that you are solving, there is a need you are meeting, there is a solution you are providing, and you are making money in the process. And I think the challenge will be, how do you move from where you are today to where you want to be 5 or so years down the line? How do you transition? How do you ensure that you are actually getting there? And yes, you have products or services that you're providing that in your arithmetics and calculations should be able to take you to go there. Then there are processes that you must follow, and you follow those processes so that you can get there sooner or later. And then, yes, you have people that helps you, even with the products and with the processes themselves. So for you really, really to get to where you want to be, ladies and gentlemen, you must be, if you are in business, there must be products that you are dealing in or services that you are providing, okay? There must be processes that will either help you get there sooner or later if you get it right. And at the heart of all these things are people. And that is why we want to concentrate on the people part of it, because the people will determine the next two, and even more, by the way, I just picked these three. And therefore, you need people to drive innovations. If you must innovate around your products, if you must innovate around your processes, then certainly you need people to be able to help you do that. And then you need people to be able to manage competitiveness. And yes, your products and your processes assist you in terms of your journey to be competitive, but the people are the driving force behind your competitiveness. The people, I repeat, are the driving force behind your competitiveness. So if you must be competitive in your business, we generally believe that you will be so because of the caliber and because of the quality of the people that you have onboarded to help you in the business. Then I promise you that there will be very harsh terrains sooner or later. In fact, there is a guy that said, at any time of your life, you are either in a problem, or you have just come out of a problem, or you are about to get into a problem. That is Les Brown, who said that. And whether it is because of COVID-19 or because of the effects of globalization, where you find China or India or Turkey or some other people are actually opening shops and opening businesses in your neighborhood and doing exactly what you are doing and doing it at half the cost, I want to assure you that harsh terrains will always be there in business. So what is critical then is, how do you manage yourself when such harsh terrains shows up? How do you navigate through that? And I want to submit to us that what will help you is generally the caliber and the quality, the way you have managed your people, even during good times, will play in a big role in terms of what happens to you and your business as you navigate these harsh terrains, as I put it. Then the people also will help you in terms of the management of your growth and profitability. In fact, if you will grow, you will grow because of people. When I look at my business, then I attribute it a lot to some things that we didn't do as people. Not that it just didn't do well. Even during this COVID, by the way, I have a lot of I have seen it live in my own business and the way things. By the way, I have an IT company which I didn't tell you, which we do Navision ERP. Although I don't manage it, there is a team that manages it. I just oversee from a distance. There is a whole team that manages it. but it has struggled again because of the people involved. And therefore, the way you will grow has everything to do with the caliber and the people that you have. Whether you will be a profitable business or not, again, depends on the people that you have. But as a business owner, the convergence of everything into one person, that is you, means generally you need to be smart and strategic in your business decisions. And one clear way to do so is in the way you recruit and manage your employees. You know, as Kenyans, we are, and I want to tell you this because I'm a Kenyan also, we are very strange people. When Obama came in 2015, he came with Shark Tank guys. He came with people who were looking for opportunities of $1 billion+. And the verdict that the Obama team made after the 2015 visit to Kenya was very disturbing. You know, they said Kenyans generally think small, which is okay. We think small and we remain small, unfortunately. Now, I want to submit to you that if you want to go far, you can't go alone. You need employees. You need very good employees. They are the keys to the future. If you want your business to move from 10 million to 100 million, I guarantee you with precision, the only miracle you need is the miracle of employees. The only miracle, I know many of us Kenyans, we are very religious. In fact, John Beattie, there is a guy called John Beattie, a writer and author. He said Africans are notoriously religious. They even pray when they are going to steal. Now, I want to tell you the miracle you need for your business to transition from 10 million to 100 million is a miracle of the caliber of employees that you have. If you do correctly, employees will help address operational issues and you will have a very, very bright future. What am I trying to say? That employees, human resource, is one of the keys and a critical one for that matter to the future. If you must reach and have a better future, I want to let you know that you will be able to do it depending on the kind of employees that you have. So my terms of reference, which basically becomes our terms of reference for today's discussion, is HRM or human resource management during lean times. So a few facts as we move on. During lean times, businesses, and I bet even yours, will experience limited inflow of cash because of low sales. The number two, they will face challenges in managing fixed and variable expenses because of allocation of funds. Funds are limited. You have not generated a lot of cash inflow. So being able to apportion and know that this 1,000 should go to this area instead of this area becomes a challenge. And I'm saying this because, you know, all this will boil down to the employees that you have because you rely on them to make decisions. So yes, you have fixed costs and variable expenses that needs to be attended to, and you have limited funds. Okay, businesses are not able to meet most of its obligations because of an availability of cash again. And yes, a lot of things you saw in the news this week, that the loans shot, non-performing loans in banks shot significantly during this COVID season because businesses were not able to afford. And you can see yesterday, most parents were up in arms because of Makoha's declaring that Monday is school opening for Form 4s, Class 8, and even the Grade 4, because people don't have enough money, okay? Now, businesses may also not be able to keep all employees because of the burden of payroll. I am one of them. So number four hit me hard, the burden of payroll. I suffered there, but we'll discuss what to do and how to do it. And then may not be able to do training and development if you used to do it for employees due to limited cash flow. And then number six, may not sustain payment of some of the benefits previously enjoyed by employees. Can you imagine? You know, some companies and some businesses, they give certain privileges or fringe benefits to employees. And now that things are south, you are not able to do that. Okay. And then lastly, businesses may stretch some of the employees due to merging of functions and reduction of headcount. So depending on what business you have, certainly if you are a two-man business, then you may not experience a lot of those that relate much to employees. But if you were a big business and you had 15 employees or 20 employees, like now I had 23, so we had to collapse some of the functions. We had to suspend some of the functions. We had to put on hold some of the functions so that we concentrate on what can generate some cash so that at least we can be able to move.